Hello, and thank you for standing by for JD.com's third quarter 2024 earnings conference call. At this time, all participants are in a listen-only mode. After management's prepared remarks, there will be a question-and-answer session. Today's conference is being recorded. If you have any objections, you may disconnect at this time. I would now like to turn the meeting over to your host for today's conference, Sean Zhang, Director, Investor Relations. Please go ahead.
Thank you. Good day, everyone. Welcome to JD.com third quarter 2024 earnings conference call. For today's call, CEO of JD.com, Ms. Sandy Xu, will kick off with her opening remarks, and our CFO, Ms. Yan Shan, will discuss the financial results, and then we'll open the call to questions from analysts. Before turning the call over to Sandy, let me quickly cover the safe harbor. Please be reminded that during this call, our comments and responses to your questions reflect management's view as of today only and will include forward-looking statements, and please refer to our latest safe harbor statement in the earnings press release on our website, which applies to this call. We'll discuss certain non-GAAP financial measures. Please also refer to the reconciliation of non-GAAP measures to the comparable GAAP measures in the earnings press release. Also, please note all figures mentioned in this call are in RMB unless otherwise stated. Now, let me turn the call over to our CEO, Sandy.
Thank you, Sean. Hello, everyone. Thanks for joining us today to discuss our Q3 2024 results. We had a solid Q3 with improved operating and financial results. Our top-line growth accelerated sequentially. Our active user base and shopping frequency expanded with stronger momentum, and our bottom line achieved another substantial uplift. At the heart of these achievements is our relentless focus on building supply chain capabilities and logistics infrastructure, which enable us to continuously unleash strength in delivering lower cost, higher efficiency, and best-in-class user experience. This is the key competitive strength that we are focused on as we face an ever-changing macro and competitive landscape. JD has been dedicated to establishing core supply chain capabilities since day one, along with putting significant efforts into building out retail and logistics infrastructures around the country to better serve consumers and contribute to the real economy of local areas nationwide. This enables us to play a key role in contributing in the trade-in program, both online and offline. JD is best positioned to support this program, not only with our strong user mindshare in home appliance and 3C categories, but more importantly, with our supply chain capabilities and our fulfillment infrastructure. Consumers are attracted to JD's platform for the wealth of product selections. Our integrated service, covering every step from dismantling, shipment to installation of the heavy, bulky appliances, and smooth checkout process using trade-in subsidies. The trade-in program has proven to be very effective in unlocking consumption potential and driving the technological upgrade of the entire industry chain, and we expect to continue to play our role in this effort to better serve customers and suppliers, stimulate consumption, and promote healthy industry development. Turning to general merchandise category, in Q3, its revenues increased by 8% year-on-year, a healthy momentum that has been sustained for three consecutive quarters this year. It was primarily attributable to our supermarket category, which delivered another double-digit revenue growth year-on-year in the quarter. As a key growth driver for us, the supermarket category continued to enrich its product portfolio in the quarter to cover different price tiers. it has also launched many initiatives, such as direct shipment from suppliers to customers, that gained strong traction among our users. As such, with improving user experience, we saw healthy increase in both user base and user engagement in supermarket, particularly with a robust 20% increase in shopping frequency during the quarter. Also notably, within our fashion category, apparel and sports and outdoors both recorded double-digit revenue growth year-on-year during the quarter, thanks to our efforts to enrich product selection, enhance user experience, and drive user mindshare of shopping for clothing on JD. It's clear that our supply chain strength is at the core of our progress in operations and financials. In addition to that, going forward, we will continue to focus on a few key areas to drive our high quality, sustainable growth in the long run. First, user growth and engagement. We've seen a set of encouraging results resulting from our efforts and investments in users. The number of our quarterly active customers has been growing at double-digit rates year-on-year for the last four quarters in a row, with Q3 being the highest. The growth was distributed across market tiers and user groups, including new and existing users. In addition, in Q3, user shopping frequency maintained double-digit year-on-year growth, primarily driven by our increased price competitiveness, category mix shift, and wider coverage of free shipping service. Our JD Plus program is on the right track, as we saw a set of metrics, including active Plus member number and shopping frequency, continue to improve. All this progress in user growth and engagement really speaks to the fact that we've been providing best-in-class experience to users of different income spectrums and demands with the right products, price, and service offerings. On such robust momentum, we will continue to invest with discipline in user growth and user experience. In addition to users, let me share some progress we made on price competitiveness and platform ecosystem. We further improved our price competitiveness as we continue to leverage on the strength of our 1P supply chain capabilities, as well as our enriched 3P product offerings and white label goods. As a result, we are better able to serve both our existing users and new users, and our NPS for price competitiveness increased year-on-year for another quarter. Particularly, we saw a steeper trajectory of user base expansion and order volume growth in lower tier markets compared to that of higher tier markets on our platform. Low price is the very essence of retail, and our commitment to that will never change. To reinforce our everyday low price user mindshare, we have launched a series of campaigns, such as the monthly Super 18 sales that offers a selection of discounted products on the 18th of every month, the weekly Black Friday, offering deals that mainly cover supermarket category, the daily late night flash sales, Yuehefenggao, offering deep discounts for limited time and limited supply, as well as the half price clothing promotions. These offerings are highly welcomed by our users. Last but not least, we also continue to make progress on our platform ecosystem. We onboarded more 3P merchants during the quarter, particularly SMEs and those from industry belts, to expand our product offerings at different price tiers. As such, our active merchant base maintained a very healthy year-on-year growth. More importantly, we also made solid progress in the quarter in user engagement, which led to accelerated year-on-year growth in 3P order volume and the number of users who purchased 3P products on our platform, both of which reached record high growth levels in Q3. Our NPS for 3P offerings rose year-on-year as well. As to monetization, commission revenues returned to a positive growth in Q3, in line with our expectation as the impact of discounted commission fees fully lapsed. Advertising revenues in our retail business grew by double digits year-on-year, thanks to the healthy growth of our ecosystem and improving traffic allocation efficiency for both 1P and 3P merchants. That said, we are still at the very beginning of exploring the potential of our platform ecosystem to drive our business scale and profitability. We will continue to prioritize further optimizing our tools and infrastructure to better empower merchants, hence further improving user experience on our platform. That's the wrap up for our Q3. Moving into Q4, we've just concluded Singles Day grand promotion. With this year's theme of cheaper and better, our supply chain trends were brought into full display. Our team did a great job expanding product assortment for both our 1P and 3P offerings, providing competitive prices and serving users with best-in-class experience. We saw users respond well, with user number and order volume both recording double-digit growth during the promotion. Finally, we are very encouraged by a more supportive policy environment that aims to realize the huge potential of consumption in China and at the same time drive industry upgrades, create employment and lift household income, which will further fuel consumption confidence. While we see consumer sentiment starts to improve, we understand it takes time for the benefits of the policies to feed through. We will continue to focus on executing our strategies in place, building up supply chain capabilities, and fully tapping into our potentials to drive lower cost, higher efficiency, and best-in-class user experience. We believe this will lead us to further expand our market share and profits. With that, I'll turn it over to Ian for our financial highlights. Thank you.
Thank you, Sandy, and hello, everyone. In Q3, our top line group accelerated from last quarter and outpaced the group of domestic total retail sales, driven by strength across our major business segments and categories. Our general merchandise category continued with strong momentum in the quarter. And more importantly, we saw a turnaround in revenue growth in our electronics and home appliances category due to our comprehensive support for China's nationwide trading program. With our strong user mindshare, supply chain capabilities, and logistics services that we have built over the past two decades, we are able to provide superior customer experience and bring value to business partners and the society at large. We also achieved an increase in profitability during the quarter as we continue to improve cost and efficiency, especially on the logistics side. Both gross margin and the non-GAAP net margin expanded at a solid pace year over year in the quarter. Moreover, we continue to return value to shareholders. During the quarter, we completed our share repurchase program announced in March this year and launched a new $5 billion US share repurchase program for the next 3 years through the end of August 2027. In detail, we repurchased a total of 31 million Class A ordinary shares, equivalent to 15.5 million ADS, which accounted for 1.1% of our ordinary shares outstanding as of June 30, 2024. the total value of the shares repurchased in Q3 was approximately $390 million. During the 9 months ending September 30, 2024, the total value of the shares repurchased was $3.65 billion, which accounted for 8.1% of our ordinary shares outstanding as of the end of 2023. The progress reflects our commitment to creating value for shareholders. With that, let me turn to our Q3 financial performance. Our net revenues grew by 5% year-on-year to RMB 260 billion in Q3, of which product revenues were up 5%. By category, revenues of electronics and home appliances grew by 3% year-on-year, with growth improving sequentially in each of these 3 months. September was notably strong for home appliances and PCs, due to our contribution to the trading program, which has been proven very effective in boosting overall consumption. And we've seen this upbeat momentum sustained on our platform in Q4 quarter to date, including during a single day grand promotion. Of note, it's our unparalleled supply chain capabilities and keen focus on user experience that set us apart from peers in the industry. Revenues of general merchandise recorded another solid growth of 8% year-on-year in the quarter, of which revenues of supermarket category, apparel, and the sports and outdoors or fashion category also double-digit increase year-on-year. With massive TAM and our investment in building user experience and user mindshare in the general merchandise category, we believe there is significant headroom for us to drive further growth over time. Service revenues grew by 7% year-on-year in Q3, of which marketplace and marketing revenues up 6%, and logistics and other service revenues up 7%. For marketplace and marketing, commission revenues returned to positive growth in the quarter, as the impacts of our discounted fees to merchants fully lapsed. Advertising revenues maintained solid momentum, with advertising revenues from JD Retail recording another double-digit year-on-year growth in Q3. Key operating metrics of our platform ecosystem showed positive progress in user engagement, including a steady increase in 3P order volume and active users who purchased 3P products on our platform. Now, let's turn to our segment performance. JD Retail revenues were up 6% year-on-year in Q3, thanks to the turnaround of electronics and home appliances and the robust growth of general merchandise. Moreover, JD Retail recorded another meaningful gross margin improvement in the quarter as we continue to drive better scale benefits of 1P, favorable mix shift towards higher margin categories, and higher contribution of 3P. As a result, we are able to pass over the savings to our users and offer them an enriched portfolio of quality products of different price tiers. The achievement in gross margin offset the increase in our operating expense, especially in marketing expense, as we devoted efforts to drive user group and user engagement. As a result, JD Retail's non-GAAP operating income increased by 6% year-on-year, and operating margin stayed stable at 5.2% in Q3, compared to the same period last year. Now, looking to JD Logistics. JD Logistics revenues increased by 7% year-on-year in Q3. This was due to healthy momentum in both internal and external revenues, which increased by 8% and 6% year-on-year, respectively, as JD Logistics continue to unlock economy of scale and rise operating efficiency. It made outside improvement across profit lines during the quarter. In particular, its non-GAAP operating income increased by 624% year-on-year, and operating margin came in at 4.7%, up 400 bps. compared to a year ago. Going forward, we expect JD Logistics' higher efficiency and superior service will continue to benefit JD Group as a critical component of our integrated supply chain. Turning to new business. In the quarter, revenue of new business was down 26% year-on-year, mostly due to the adjustment of the Jingxi business. Non-GAAP operating loss of new business was RMB 616 million in the quarter, compared to a loss of RMB 192 million a year ago. The result was largely due to the increased loss in Jingxi. Moving on to our consolidated profit performance. In Q3, at the group level, gross profit grew by 16% year-on-year, and gross margin grew by 165 bps to 17.3%. It's the 10th quarter in a row, with our gross margin expansion on a year-on-year basis, a strong proof of our high-quality development path. Moreover, our non-GAAP operating income increased by 18% year-on-year, and operating margin came in at 5% in Q3, up 54 bps year-on-year. Non-GAAP net profit attributable to ordinary shareholders increased by 24% year-on-year, and net margin came in at 5.1%, up 76 bps year-on-year. We are well on track to achieve our long-term margin target, with some of the previous quarters already reaching it. For the full year of 2024, we're confident to achieve double-digit growth of our non-GAAP net profit. Our last 12-month free cash flow as of the end of Q3 was RMB 34 billion, compared to RMB 39 billion in the same period last year. The decrease was the result of the timing difference of our working capital and the impact of the trading program, which was partially offset by our increased profit and moderated CapEx. By the end of Q3, our cash and cash equivalents, restricted cash and short-term investments added up to a total of RMB 197 billion. To conclude, we had a very solid Q3, with both top and bottom lines trending in the right direction. Looking ahead, we're more confident in the economic environment and the vitality of domestic consumption. We look forward to fully utilizing our core capabilities to play our role in the implementation of the government's stimulus measures. We will continue to execute our strategies in supply chain, price competitiveness, and platform ecosystem to create value for our users, business partners, and shareholders along the way. With that, I will turn it back to Sean. Thank you.
Thank you, Ian. For the Q&A session, you are welcome to ask questions in Chinese or English, and our management will answer your question in the language you have. We'll provide English translation when necessary for convenient purpose only. In case of any discrepancy, please refer to our management statement in original language. Okay, now, operator, we can open the call for Q&A session.
Thank you. The question and answer session of this conference call will start in a moment. In order to be fair to all callers who wish to ask questions, we will take one question at a time from each caller. If you have more than one question, please request to join the question queue again after your first question has been addressed. If you wish to ask a question, please press star 1 on your telephone and wait for your name to be announced. If you wish to cancel your request, please press star 2. If you're on a speakerphone, please pick up the handset to ask your question. Your first question comes from Ronald Keung from Goldman Sachs. Please go ahead.
谢谢 Sandy, Ian 和 Sean. 那想问一下我们这个增长的，那 这个以旧换新政策出来以后，能帮我们量化一下这个在三季度和可能四季度能带来的哪些这个增量有多少吗？以及这个 增速来讲，这个持续性，尤其我们看到，比如明年一二季度还是明年，我们应该怎么看这个持续性？然后除了这个以旧换新政策以外呢，那想听一下我们对京东接下来的增长的主要的驱动力。那我们应该有哪些对于商超刚才说了日百三 P 价格力和服务，那我们这个最新的有哪些战略和进展来保持我们跑得比这个社零大盘更快的这个目标。那谢谢，我翻译一下。Thank you, management, for taking the question. I have a question on our growth, and we've seen the trading of appliance trading programs. Could you help us just quantify the boost to third quarter and potentially into the fourth quarter, and how is the sustainability of this heading into next year for the policy-wide boost to appliance? And then excluding appliance, what are our strategies in supermarket, general merchandise, 3P and price competitiveness to sustain the strategy for next year if we want to keep the target of growing above retail industry growth? Thank you.
谢谢 Donald 的问题。那就的确过去一段时间政府陆续出台了一系列的支持经济和消费的政策，那其中也包括消费品以旧换新，那目前已经在全国各地大范围的都开展起来了，那也取得了很积极的进展。在政府相关部门的统筹下呢，那京东我们也凭借着自身多年来深耕的供应链优势快速响应，那也通过我们自己的备货，然后提高效率，升级服务，让这个好产品好价格好服务可以直达我们的用户，可以覆盖更多的消费者。那么我想强调是说，京东能够在短时间内快速响应，全力的支持以旧换新的工作，主要还是得益于我们多年都在以旧换新这个领域主动的做了很多的积累，包括技术上和系统上面的整合能力，也包括我们自营的运营能力、物流的履约，还有搭建配送安装这些差异化的服务能力。那么同时呢，用户对买家电商京东的心智也有高度的认可，所以本次这个以旧换新活动的开展，那我们很自然而然就成为这个众多消费者买家电的首选。
Thank you, Ronald. To take your first question, so in recent months, the government has been rolling out a series of stimulus measures, including the trading policy nationwide, to support economic growth and consumption. And these efforts have shown positive progress. And under the comprehensive planning of the government bodies, JDE has swiftly responded by increasing inventory and enhancing service efficiency to support the program. Leveraging our extensive experience in supply chain management, we are well positioned to offer quality products and convenient services at competitive prices to a broad base of Chinese consumers. So here what I want to emphasize is that our swift response to the trade-in program is due to our years of experience in proactively providing trade-in services, which has made us technologically prepared and systematically compatible with such initiatives. Additionally, JD's unique supply chain capabilities, including our self-operated sales model, logistics and fulfillment capabilities, and large item services, and combined with our strong user mindshare in the home appliances category, have made us the preferred partner and preferred supplier for our customers in the trading program.
对，那么从以旧换新的效果上来看呢，我们也看到以旧换新的国补取得了积极的进展成效。那大家其实可以从统计局九月带电品类的这个增速，相对于七月和八月份的明显改善上，可以一定程度上反映这个国补的效果。那么从京东的角度，我们其实也看到了这个非常相似的趋势。那么我们平台上九月份家电和电脑品类的需求也跟七月八月对比有一个明显的提升。那么整个三季度呢，其实整体销售的增速是呈逐月提高的趋势。
So on the effects of the trading program, we've seen promising outcomes so far. The National Bureau of Statistics reported that September sales of household appliances and consumer electronics grew significantly compared to July and August. So this trend is also mirrored on JD.com, where the trading program has driven our increased demand of sales for home appliances and computer in September. Our sales on these categories increased sequentially in each of the 3 months in Q3.
那么值得注意的是呢，这个在三季度其实国补的效果还没有完全的释放出来。那一方面呢，就是消费者他有一个教育的过程，就是还并不是所有的用户都了解这个政策。那么，但是呢，另外一方面就是短期这些品类也会受到产能不足的限制，因此从品牌商的角度，他们扩产能也需要一定的周期。 所以有一些商品也出现了供不应求的现象。那么，刚刚结束的全国人大会议上，其实，如果大家关注政府的这个发布的公告，也讲到说要结合明年经济社会发展目标来实施更加给力的财政政策，包括扩大消费品以及换新的品种和规模。那从我们的角度，我们也认为这个政策延续下去对提振消费是很有帮助的。
But at the same time, it is also noteworthy that the full potential of the trading policy has yet to be fully realized in Q3. By part, it's because some of the consumers haven't been fully aware of this policy. It takes some time for them to be educated and to take advantage of this trading policy. And on the other side, due to some limited production capacity, the high consumer demand for some subsidized products may not be fully met in the short term, and for the brands and the manufacturers, they may require time to ramp up production. Additionally, at the recent National People's Congress meeting, the government just unveiled to introduce more forceful fiscal stimulus plan basing on next year's economic and social development objective, and expanding the trading program in greater scale and categories of consumer goods is a measure included in this supportive plan. We believe extending the trading policy would further support consumer spending.
对，我们理解国家推进消费品以及换新补贴，其实不仅仅是为了刺激短期的消费，那么更重要的呢，还是希望通过这个努力来带动产业的健康发展，从而带动就业和增加居民的收入。 来扭转消费信心的趋势，所以我们也期待消费信心能够持续加强，这对整个零售行业和这个各种各样的制造业其实都是好事。那我们认为政策持续下去并扩大到更多品类的意义也是很大的。那到目前为止呢，我们看到就是我们平台上面对于家电和电脑这两个品类的消费需求继续在稳步提升。 而且伴随着更多用户来京东参与以及换新，那我们平台的流量和访问也在加速增长，所以我们也将继续去围绕成本效率体验来提升，包括我们带电品类、商超和时尚等品类的供应链能力，为用户提供又便宜又好的购物体验。We
believe the government trading program is not solely aimed at boosting short-term consumption, but also at fostering the healthy development of key industries, creating jobs and increasing household income, and restore consumer confidence. And strengthened consumer confidence benefits the entire retail and all sorts of manufacturing sector. And we hope the policy will continue and expand to other categories to sustain this meaningful momentum. And currently, this program remains attractive to consumers as reflected during JD's Singles Day Grand promotion, where our home appliances and computer sales continue to grow steadily. And moreover, the trading program has increased the traffic and visits on JD's platform. We're committed to enhancing our supply chain across all categories, electronics, supermarket and fashion, etc., focusing on cost efficiency and user experience to deliver cheaper and better shopping experiences to our customers.
对，然后第二个问题是关于增长策略啊。那么， 其实过去这一年以来，我们始终围绕着用户体验、成本效率，在持续推进我们各项这个战略和策略的落地。那么首先呢，在价格竞争力上，我们这个始终都会坚持，就是持续通过提升我们供应链的规模和效率，去不断降低我们的自营采购成本，来持续带来更低的商品价格。那另外呢，就是对于非品牌商品也会持续的通过我们的这个 POP 模式和我们的增品模式来吸引更多的优质白牌产业带商家和更多的低价优质的商品选择，来满足不同的用户多样性的需求。与此同时，刚刚我也提到过，我们也打造了包括每个月的超级十八，每周的针对商超品类的黑色星期五，和每天晚上限时限量的月黑新高这些日常的营销活动矩阵，来不断加深用户对京东天天低价 EDLP 的认知。
Regarding your second question on growth strategies, this year we have steadily advanced our strategic plans, focusing on enhancing user experience, optimizing costs, and boosting efficiency. So, on enhancing price competitiveness, our ongoing strategies include our continuous lowering our 1P procurement costs by scaling our supply chain and increasing efficiency.That allow us to offer products at more competitive price. At the same time, to increase the supplies of non-brand products, we are introducing more white label sellers and affordable products through our channels like 3P and Jingxi business models to cater to the diverse shopping needs across user groups. At the same time, we strive to strengthen the everyday low price user mindshare.By building our promotional metrics, as I mentioned in my remark, such as the monthly Super 18 sales, the weekly Black Friday deals on supermarket categories, and the daily late night flash sale events.
对，然后我们的日版品类呢，也继续保持着快于社零大盘的健康增长。那特别是在商超品类，那我们今年也推出了仓网变革来提升效率。那么在三季度呢，继续取得双位数的增长，同时他们的盈利能力也在逐步改善。那么在服饰品类上，我们在九月开始，大家可能也看到，我们也加强了这个品类的投入。那我们也做了买服装上京东的活动。那么在三季度，我们的服装品类也取得了双位数的增长。
So on the general merchandise category in Q3, it also maintained healthy growth and continued to outperform the market. And specifically on the supermarket category, we focused on our reform of the warehouse network for greater efficiency. And this approach led to double-digit revenue growth in Q3 along with improved profitability. And on the fashion category since September, we have increased the investments on user side,mainly focusing on reinforcing users' mindshare of shopping for clothing on JD. And this focus contributed to double-digit year-on-year growth in clothing categories and other subcategories in Q3.
对，在平台生态建设上呢，刚刚也分享了，就是我们的第三方 3P 的业务，那也取得了就是各个指标都很健康。这里我就不再重复了。那么在这几个方面呢，其实我们还会持续的继续往前推进。虽然到目前为止都取得了不错的成绩，但是依然还有挺大的提升空间。那么长期来看，我们有信心保持高于社零大盘的增速，不断的获取市场份额。
So, and thirdly, on the strengthening of our platform ecosystem on the 3P part, I've already mentioned, I won't repeat, there's a lot of healthy growth has been achieved across different metrics, whereas we see there's still plenty room to improve in many aspects. So overall, we are confident in our ability to sustain a faster than market growth rate and continue expanding our market share. Thank you.
谢谢 Sandy.
Thank you. Your next question comes from Alicia Yap from Citigroup. Please go ahead.
Good evening, 管理层, 晚上好, 谢谢接受我的提问, 恭喜这个强劲的业绩哈, 我有两个很快的问题, 一个就是跟进一下, 就是我们刚刚说到, 就京东受益政府这个以旧换新刺激嘛, 然后其实房地产这个稳定性, 其实也带动了这个家电的这个需求增长, 但是呢, 就最近其实蛮多投资, 投资者其实是关注到明年, 尤其是我们下半年的这个增长驱动力, 其实担心就是说家电这边是会有个高基数, 然后可能导致我们明年的增速会放缓, 我们认为如果 房地产其实市场有进一步的稳定的话, 其实可能可以带来更 可以持续的这个价链需求, 这个是我们的想法哈, 不知道京东管理层这边对这个增长的会不会就有什么看法哈, 然后请管理层介绍一下就是说明年的一些增长驱动力, 然后第二个问题就是说最近几个季度其实公司的这个 盈利利润增长都是超预期哈, 然后其中一个主要是这个物流这边的这个利润率的提升, 然后零售这边其实成本优化, 效率提升等, 但京东今年其实已经实现了很好的利润提升, 能否请管理层就是分享一下明年如果公司明年有一些什么样的一个投入方向, 整体的一个利润率、利润增长的一个初步的想法吧。然后我这边很快翻译一下, 就, thanks for taking my questions. Two questions. First is that it's good that JD has been benefiting from the appliance trade-in stimulus, and also with the stabilizations of the real estate sector, which likely have attracted the demand for appliance in the end of 3Q and also into the 4Q. But investors lately have a new concern about the growth driver into next year, especially for the second half of next year, and worry that there might be a high base for appliance sales and also JD's growth might slow down. We would try to argue that if real estate actually stabilize, further stabilize, which could actually drive more sustainable demand for appliance, and it may not necessarily seeing a rollover of the growth for JD. So what is management view for this? Appreciate if we can address all the various JD growth driver into the next year. Second question is, one of the bigger boosts of better than expected profit beat the last quarter that we deliver, likely to have driven by JD logistic margin improvement and also JD retail cost optimization and also the efficiency improvement. Just, you know, JD also has delivered very good profit improvement already this year. As we head into next year, 2025, can management provide any preliminary thoughts in terms of the investment, the spending that you might want to invest, and how would overall margins and profit growth outlook heading into next year? Thank you.
谢谢Alicia，非常好的问题啊。那我先来回答第一个问题。我们的理解就是这个以旧换新的补贴，就像我刚刚说的，我觉得它是一个更多的是一个杠杆的作用, 就是它不仅仅是为了刺激短期在家电品类的消费, 而更重要的是通过这个努力去撬动更好的就业, 然后增加居民的收入, 然后扭转消费信心的趋势。 那我个人的观点是，这个消费信心如果一旦增强, 其实对于我们京东我们最擅长的品类和我们这个用户群体, 这个意义要更大一些，所以对于明年我们还是持谨慎乐观的态度啊。那然后呢，关于这个增长的驱动力，其实刚刚这个跟第一个问题已经回答过一些，我觉得那可能我们还是就坚持一个是说在我们的这个长期的策略上，那么我们这个关注用户的体验和用户的增长。 那然后呢，继续去推动我们这些我们认为比较有潜力的品类的扩张，以及不同价格带的商品的扩张。那么特别是下沉市场用户所喜爱的那些产业带的商品呢，这些我们也在侧重于投入很多的努力去推动这些业务的发展。那然后当然这个与此相关的就是我们的这个平台生态的持续的发展，所以这几个都还是会是我们 这个持续的增长驱动力吧。
And thank you, Alicia, for your question. I will address the first part on the growth. So as I just mentioned, our belief is that for the trading policies the government introduced is playing a role as a leverage. It is not only aimed at like short-term consumption increase for the home appliances categories, but more play a role to boost the consumption with the job created and increase the household income to restore consumption confidence. So in my opinion, the confidence, consumption confidence restoring is more meaningful to help JD's growth in terms of the specific categories and our targeted groups. So for the next year, we remain cautiously optimistic for the overall economic and consumption growth trajectory. And in terms of our company's growth drivers, and we will continue to carry out our long-term strategic plans, mainly focused on first to continue to foster our users' experience and user growth, and continue to invest on those categories that have a high growth potentials and expand our product offerings and with a wider range of prices that cater to the needs of the lower tier markets and introduce more products from the industrial belts, etc. We are making steady efforts to invest in these businesses. And thirdly, we continue to invest in our platform ecosystem to provide a thriving environment for everyone to continue to grow.
Alicia, 关于利润方面，然后那首先长期看京东的利润率提升主要有三个驱动因素。第一个是京东在供应链上的规模和效率优势将继续释放出来。那从刚发布的 Q3 的财报，大家可以看到我们的净利率是逐步继续提升的。那这主要得益于我们通过供应链的效率带动商品毛利率的持续提升，以及物流价本增效带来的利润提升。那第二呢，从品类结构上看，我们很多品类的利润率还有很大的提升空间，包括商超等，以及品类结构的变化也会带来利润的提高。那从自营和 3P 的结构上呢，随着 3P 业务在长期占比不断提高，可以带动利润率的持续提升。
So regarding the prospects on profits, I'd like to share our thoughts. So first, our long-term profit margin improvement will be driven by three key factors.So JD's strength in supply chain scale and efficiency will continue to drive margin growth. As you can see in our Q3's earnings, we saw a continuous increase in our net margins, which is mainly due to the gross profit margin improvement in product supply chain and JD logistic profit growth driven by cost management and the efficiency improvement. And the second driver is the category mix.There is still significant potential for margin improvement in many categories, such as the supermarket category. Additionally, favorable category mix shift itself can also lead to higher margin. And the third driver is our 1P versus 3P mix. As the ratio of 3P business grows over time on our platform, it will also positively impact our margin growth.
同时我们也会结合宏观和市场环境的变化，然后以及自身的长期战略布局，坚持在用户体验和增长、核心的供应链能力、品类心智等方向坚定的有纪律的投入，然后为长期布局。长期来看，我们的利润率会随着业务的健康发展和运营效益的提升而持续提升。京东长期的利润率目标将会达到各个位数，那具体到明年的具体的增长和利润指引，我们会在合适时间跟大家沟通。
So, in line with JD's long-term strategies and in response to the macroeconomic and market changes, we will continue investing in areas that enhance user experience, strengthen our core supply chain capabilities, and build user mindshare in specific categories. And maintaining strategic focus on long-term planning is crucial for our business success. Over the long run, our profit margin will continue to improve alongside healthy business growth and increased operating efficiency. and JD's long-term profit margin goal will reach a high single digit. As for specific growth and profit guidance, we'll share at appropriate time. Thank you.
Next question, please. Thank you.
Thank you. Your next question comes from Kenneth Fong from UBS. Please go ahead.
Hey, 晚上好, 谢谢管理层接受我的提问。 我有两个问题。 第一个是关于这个竞争跟投入的。 在31的期间, 我们看到各个电商平台从入库装也不要自己去投入, 然后商家端也有很大力度的扶持的政策。 管理层可否分享一下目前的竞争态势是怎么样的？ 我们刚刚也讲到一些公司的投入的方向, 所以再展开讲一下就是我们集中会在哪一个方面, 对这个利润率会有什么影响呢？ 关于投入的话, 我有另外一个问题就是关于服装跟美妆的。 因为我们看到新闻里面讲, 京东会在这个布局服装、美妆, 会分别投入10个亿跟30个亿。 能否分享一下这个投入的方向? 这些品类的话会以一个1P为主, 还是3P的运营的模式呢? 目前有什么成效? 然后长远来看的话, 怎么思考, 京东在这些品类的长期定位跟优势呢? 我继续翻译一下。 My first question is about competition and investment. During Double 11, e-commerce platform have been investing aggressively on both users and merchants. So can management share your view on the current industry competitive landscape? Also, for area for Jingdong investment, and for this investment, how should we think about the impact on margin? My second question is on the expansion in the apparel and cosmetic category. Because in the news, we saw that we are investing $3 and $1 billion respectively on cosmetic and apparel category. So can management share more about that? Would it be 1P or 3P in terms of operation? And any results that we can share? And then more medium to longer term, what is JD competitive advantage versus peers in our positioning in this category? Thank you.
Kenny, 我来回答您关于行业竞争和公司投入的问题。首先，我们的观点始终是中国的零售消费市场庞大，具有非常适合电商发展的人口结构和分布，而且具有世界上最发达的电商市场的基础设施，包括物流、支付、社交等基础设施建设都非常发达，因此中国的电商市场还有很大的渗透和提升空间。
近期包括以旧换新在内的一系列支持消费政策不断落地，那消费趋势逐步向好，也将为电商带来新的增长动力。Hi, Kenny. Thanks for your question. I will take the question on the industry competition and our investment. So first of all, I want to stress that we continue to hold the view that China is a highly promising retail market supported by favorable demographic structure and distribution, along with the world's most advanced e-commerce infrastructure, including robust logistics, payment systems, and social media integration, et cetera. So there's still significant room for e-commerce to expand its market penetration. And with the implementation of supportive measures to boost consumption, including the recent trading policy, we're seeing positive momentum that will inject fresh growth energy in e-commerce.
然后在这种大趋势下，京东的投入将会始终聚焦在提升用户体验和用户增长上。我们会围绕着成本、效率、体验不断地建设差异化的1P的能力，打造自己的核心能力和护城河，有针对性地在加深自营供应链和物流履约等能力建设上做长期可持续的投入，并不断地强化用户心智。 那一些具体的进展可以跟大家分享。那在用户体验上，在过去一年，我们在持续提升价格竞争力，降低自营免邮门槛，然后做好服务、免费上门退换货等方面提升用户体验。例如，我们现在已经将59免包邮免费上门退换等服务从自营商品扩展到了Hop商品，还推出了晚发腿等创新的服务，不遗余力地为用户提供超预期的购物体验。 那在不断提升用户体验的同时，我们也在积极地吸引新用户。 那Q3季度购物用户数继续保持双位数增长，且持续且呈现加速的趋势。那我们预期接下来用户数将继续保持快速增长的势头。那在打造品类新智上，我们在家电、电脑、手机等带电品类已经成为众多用户首选的购物平台。那在参与国家以旧换新落地时，我们希望通过更好的整合服务体验， 夯实用户对京东的认可，而在商超时尚的日百品类，那我们也在不断的强化用户认知，特别是九月开始，我们围绕着满服装上京东的用户心智打造，那希望可以更多的用户了解和选择京东的服装品类。So
given this e-commerce development momentum, we will maintain focus on enhancing user experience and driving user growth, developing our differentiated supply chain capabilities based on cost efficiency and user experience, and building our core capabilities and a competitive edge, making targeted investment in self-operated supply chain and logistics service for sustainable long-term growth. At the same time, continuously strengthening user mindshare. Here are some specific updates. And on user experience over the past year, we focused on enhancing user experience by increasing price competitiveness, lowering the free shipping threshold for our self-operated products, and improving our free at-home return services. And now we have extended many services from 1P to 3P products, such as free shipping for order over 59 yuan and the free home return services. Additionally, we've introduced innovative services like compensation for delayed shipping to constantly exceed user expectation. And alongside these improvements on user experience, we are actively working to attract new users. In Q3, we achieved the double digits year-on-year user growth with accelerated momentum, and we expect this growth to continue. And in terms of strengthening customer mindshare in key categories, and JD has become the go-to destination for home appliances, computers, mobile phones, and electronic category. As we support the government's trading policy, we also take the opportunity to further integrate our services to reinforce user trust on these categories. And in general merchandise categories like market, supermarket, and fashion, we continue to build a stronger user mindshare. Our promotional campaign on the apparel category launched in this September. It's a prime example of enhancing user awareness and engagement in the apparel category.
双十一期间我们也取得了不错的表现，总体上超过我们的预期。我们看到随着用户心智的提升，我们的用户流量有明显提升，京东 APP 的访问用户增速明显提升，那活跃用户和订单量均有非常好的增长，整个大促期间活跃用户数取得两位数以上的增长，平均单日购买用户数增长20%以上。 而且在此基础上，用户的购买频次也继续保持双位数的增长。总结下来，那京东将继续坚定地围绕着成本效率体验做投入，不断地提升我们差异化的以供应链为基础、以用户体验为核心的竞争优势。那在此过程当中，我们当然会关注 GMV 利润和经营流等关键指标的平衡和高质量发展。全年来看，我们非常有信心集团利润超过双位数增长。
So here, we are also pleased to share the single day's grand promotion performance, which overall exceeded our expectation. So with JD's rising user mindshare, we've seen notable improvement in user traffic, with our APP's unique visit witnessed significant increase during the shopping festival. And both the active users and orders during the shopping festival experienced fast growth. The number of active users achieved double-digit growth, and the average daily active customers increased by over 20%. At the same time, user shopping frequency maintained double-digit growth year-on-year. So all in all, we will continue to invest in reducing cost, improving efficiency, and enhancing user experience, focusing on our unique strengths in supply chain and user-centered experience. At the same time, we will closely monitor GMV, profit, cash flow, and other key metrics to achieve a balanced, high-quality growth. And for the full year, we're confident that JD Group's profit will exceed double-digit growth.
对，然后我来回答第二个问题吧。特别感谢 Kenny 关注到我们在服装美妆品类上所做出的努力和投入。那么在服装品类上呢，我们是希望进一步为用户提供丰富时尚的这些服饰美妆品产品以及更加优质的服务，来吸引更多的用户买服装上京东。那我们也会持续的打造一系列的围绕服装美妆的长期活动那包括服装真五折等等，来提升我们这个品类对消费者的吸引力，来逐步加强我们的用户心智。那么具体的在美妆品类上呢，我们会加强跟国货品牌、新兴品牌的合作，那么让这些品牌和京东一起挖掘更大的市场空间，共同成长。那我们也将百亿补贴扩展至了美妆全品类，来增强了美妆产品对消费者的吸引力。那在服装品类上呢，我们在九月份围绕买服装上京东，其实做了一系列的运营活动，那包括服装真五折这个时装周走秀等等，那也是强化我们在这个品类上的用户心智。那我们也看到这一轮活动带来了大量的高价值的新用户。那么这个今年双十一期间，那整个服装不是美妆的活跃购买用户数、购物频次等指标也都取得了很健康的增长。
So, Kenny, thank you very much for recognizing our efforts in the fashion and the beauty categories. So we've been steadily increasing our investment in these categories with the key goal to enhance user experience as part of our long-term strategy. And to build user interest and engagement with JD's apparel offerings,We are expanding our product selections, especially the good quality and fashionable product selections, and emphasizing premium services. We've been launching and will continue to plan promotions, including the 50% off campaign on the apparel category to better appeal users and increase their recognition. Specifically on the beauty products, we are strengthening partnerships with domestic and emerging beauty brands.We express the high expectation to work together on exploring market potential for common growth in these categories. And so far, our 10 billion yuan discount program has expanded to cover the entire beauty category, gaining popularity among JD users. And on the apparel product, in September, we launched several initiatives to boost JD's presence in the apparel category, such as the 50% off campaign and the London Fashion Show, showcasing.Our brand, a broad brand selection and competitive pricing. And all these campaigns have attracted new users with high purchasing power, who showed greater order values and high repurchasing rate within a month. Especially during the Singles Day Grand promotion, we see new active users in fashion and beauty, and their shopping frequency both achieved a healthy growth.
那么关于我们的运营模式目前呢，我们的这个时尚品类还是以 3P 的方式为主但的确我们也在加强这个品类的自营的操盘能力。那最终究竟选择哪一个模式还是取决于用户的选择那具体的投入的这个，我记得你刚才也有问我们投入的方式呢，其实我们的投入还是围绕着用户体验，也就是产品价格和服务。那么在产品上呢，我们也会持续优化我们的算法，然后让我们的推荐更加精准。那么在价格上面呢，就的确我们也会做一些投入，然后让用户这个体验到更优惠的、更实惠的价格。那么在服务上，我们也会打造一些差异化的服务能力。那么在四季度呢，我们围绕服装和美妆的一系列的运营活动还会坚定的长期做下去，也欢迎各位投资人和分析师都来体验一下我们的产品。如果大家有好的建议，可以随时反馈给我们，谢谢。
And in terms of the operating models, and currently most of fashion products on our platform come from 3P sellers. At the same time, we're also stepping up efforts on our 1P operational capabilities, but definitely the users will have the final say to choose between 1P and 3P.And in terms of the investments, we will continue to focus on the products, price, and the services. And we will continue to better our algorithms to promote, to introduce more tailor-made products to the relevant customers. And we will also invest in improve the price competitiveness and offer more affordable affordable products on these categories, and along with more differentiated services. And with that said, we welcome all the analysts and all these our partners to use and experience our apparel and fashion categories. And if you have any suggestions, we are very happy to hear from you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Your next question comes from Thomas Chong from Jefferies. Please go ahead.
晚上好，谢谢管理层接受我的提问。我第一个问题是关于宏观的情况的。管理层可以分享一下最新宏观政策是否对消费者的情绪已经产生了一个比较正面的影响？ 另外一个问题呢，是关于股东回报的。管理层可以分享一下最近我们的回归股东的情况吗？谢谢。Good evening, thanks management for taking my question. My first question is about the macro. Can management comment about the recent macro policies measures have any positive impact to consumer sentiment? And my second question is about capital return. Can management comment about the latest updates on shareholders' returns related to buyback and dividends? Thank you.
谢谢 Thomas 的问题。 对，我觉得首先这个 非常简单的回复就是 yes， 就是近期的宏观政策呢，我们的确看到对消费者的情绪已经产生了正面的影响。那然后呢，当然我们期待着随着政策进一步发力， 和经济基本面逐渐的好转，那么也能够看到居民的收入逐步回升。那我相信，如果这些发生的话，那消费还有很大的潜力可以进一步的释放。Thank
you, Thomas, for the question. So my short answer is yes. Current macro policies has been taking a positive effect on the overall consumption sentiment, and we expect as these policies continue to take effect, this will help to improve the economic fundamentals and to help recover and improve household income, which will all provide more energy and vitalization to the consumption potential.
Thomas, 我回答你关于股东回报的问题。那今年前三季度，我们坚定地执行了股东回报。 那长期来看，我们会业务健康增长的基础上，坚定地通过不同方式持续回馈我们的股东。那第一呢，就是回购的进展。今年前三季度，我们累计回购了36.5亿美金，那相当于截至2023年12月31日流通股数的8.1%。在三季度，我们回购了约3.9亿美金。 那么我们已经充分使用了2024年3月批准的30亿美元的股票回购计划下的金额。那么我们在 Q3宣布了新的3年50亿美金的回购计划，我们的目标是长期降低总股数。分红的进展呢？那今年上半年我们完成了12亿美金的年度分红，我们会基于利润持续进行稳定的年度分红。那长期策略上， 我们会持续的通过回购分红还有业绩交付对股东进行回报，然后分享京东业务的成功。谢谢。
And regarding the shareholder return, we have constantly executed our shareholder return plan over the first three quarters of the year, and we remain committed to delivering returns through multiple channels based on sustained business growth. And on our share repurchase progress over the first three quarters, we've repurchased $3.65 billion worth of shares, totaling approximately 255.3 million ordinary shares, or 127.6 million ADS, representing 8.1% of total shares outstanding as of December 31st, 2023. And in Q3 alone, we repurchased approximately $319 million worth of shares, and we have fully utilized the repurchase amount authorized under the $3 billion share repurchase program. And in Q3, we announced a new three-year repurchase program totaling $5 billion, which will execute with the aim of reducing total number of shares in the long run. And on the dividend progress, we completed a $1.2 billion dividend distribution for 2024 in the first half of the year and plan to continue with a steady annual dividend payment based on profitability. So for the long term, we are dedicated to rewarding shareholders through share repurchase, dividends, and the strong operational performance, sharing the value created by our business success. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Let's take the last question, please.
Thank you. Your next question comes from Jialong Shi from Nomura. Please go ahead.
Hey, 晚上好，谢谢管理层接受我的提问。我有两个很快的问题。第一个问题就是想问一下这个京东商超，想了解一下京东商超它目前的这个业务规模以及它的这个盈利能力、盈利状况是怎么样的，然后以及京东最近推出这个我们在永辉超市的这个投资，这个背后的考量是什么。第二个问题是想问一下京东在这个 3P 这边的这个潜力大概会有多大，我们打算怎么样做去挖掘我们在 3P 这边的潜力。我自己翻译一下。So I have two questions. The first question is about JD Supermarket. So just wondering, what is the size and the margin of JD Supermarket business? And what was the rationale to have decided to exit our previous investment in Yonghui Supermarket? The second question is about JD 3P. So just wondering, what does JD think of its potential in 3P, and what are your strategies to further unleash the potential of 3P? Thank you.
谢谢嘉龙的问题。那商超品类呢，一直都是我们非常重要的业务组成部分，也是我们未来增长这个最重要的驱动力之一。那商超呢，不仅是我们日版品类中的，就大家现在看到的 general merchandise 里面最大的品类，那从销售规模上来看，也比中国的任何商超连锁都要大。但是目前这个行业，如果我们看整个这个行业规模的话，那其实规模还是巨大的，它的集中度也是很低的，和这些发达国家比起来。那么今年九月份我们京东超市成立十周年庆典的时候，我也当时跟媒体讲，就京东超市是京东集团决胜下个十年的重要战场之一。所以坦白说，现在商超的业务规模以及它的盈利能力都还没有远远没有达到我们的长期目标。那我们认为长期还是有很大的发展潜力，那未来商超的健康增长我们也是充满信心的。那么今年以来呢，我们商超的增速一直保持在双位数那我们也在持续的提升我们品类的核心的经营能力，那包括我们的自营的操盘能力。那么另外呢，就是从我们的这个损益情况来看，那随着我们规模的提升以及我们精细化的运营，那还有包括我们的仓网变革，我们也看到商超的利润水平也在逐步的提升。所以这个未来的话，我们也还会持续的通过更好的产品价格服务来在这个品类上持续提升我们的用户体验，并且打造用户心智。
Thank you, Jialong, for your question. The supermarket category has always been a core part of our business and one of the most important drivers for our future growth. It represents the largest segment among our general merchandise categories and by sales volume surpasses any supermarket chain store in China. While at the same time, it's also worth noting that China's supermarket sector is vast and highly decentralized compared with other developed countries.In September, JD Super marked its 10th anniversary and emphasized during the celebration to the media that the supermarket business is one of the key battlefields that will shape JD's future in the coming decade. Admittedly, given its current scale and profitability, JD Super still have a way to go to meet our long-term expectations. However, we see significant potential in this category and remain confident.In its healthy growth trajectory. And for this year, JD Super has achieved a double-digit year-on-year growth driven by our enhanced operational capabilities. So we will continue to strengthen our core capabilities in our 1P management in terms of the scales, our refined operations, and reform in warehouse network, et cetera, to drive up the profitability and continue to centering on the product offerings price competitiveness and our differentiated services to improve user experience and users' mindshare in the supermarket category.
对，然后在永辉持股的变动呢，主要是因为我们要聚焦自身的核心业务。那然后我们也实现了当初战略投资的目的和预期合作的效果。
And our strategic investment in Yonghui matched the initial objectives we set at the beginning of the collaboration. The recent shareholding change reflects our proactive decision to sharpen our focus on JD's core business areas.
对，还有一个关于 3P 生态的潜力的问题。那么首先呢，这个我们发展平台生态的核心是通过不同的模式来为用户提供这个最优的产品价格和服务。那这个 3P 业务我觉得对于京东来说也可以很好的补充我们的品牌和商品的丰富度。所以就这个还是最终是一个用户的自然选择的过程。那么在目前看呢，我们的 3P 的业务从能力、规模和利润的贡献上还是有很大的提升空间。
And regarding the question on the 3P development, our platform ecosystem development goal is centered around enhancing user experience. We aim to offer the best products, price and services through a mix of sales models, with 3P playing a key role in expanding our selection of products and brands.So eventually, this will be our users' natural choice. And building a robust platform ecosystem, there remains substantial room for improvement in 3P operations, business scale, and profit contribution to the platform.
对，其实我们过去几年一直也在建设我们平台的基础设施和商家工具。但是坦白说呢，跟商家的预期还是有一定的差距的，所以在这个方面我们也会继续的去加大投入，然后和帮助我们的商家能够更好的去做流量运营，来以及获取用户以及用户的教育。那么我们也是期待着能够和商家实现共赢，那么让平台生态自然而然成为我们提升收入和利润的长期驱动力。
And for a period of time we have beeninvesting in the platforms, infrastructures, and providing all sorts of merchant tools. Of course, there's still a way to go to better our supplies to our merchants and to help them to better to do the traffic allocations and the user acquisition, etc., to create a win-win situation. So over time, the platform's ecosystem, we aim to have it become a long-term growth driver.Generating increased revenue and profitability. Thank you.
Thank you. We are now approaching the end of the conference call. I will now turn the call over to JD.com's Sean Zhang for closing remarks.
Thank you for joining us today on the call, and thank you for all the great questions. That's a wrap. If you have further questions, please contact me and our team.We really appreciate your interest in JD.com and look forward to talking to you again next quarter. Thank you.
Thank you for your participation in today's conference. This concludes the presentation. You may now disconnect. Good day.